Dear friends, in this video, I'll be talking about AEM installation and setup. As part of this tutorial series, we have covered the training index, what is AEM, prerequisites of AEM development, and in this video, I'll be talking about AEM installation and setup, start stop AEM server. Let us see the prerequisites for AEM installation. We need to have a JDK installed. I recommend the latest version of JDK. AEM kickstart file and a license key or file. Next is demo. In this demo, I'll be showing how to install AEM, logging into the AEM, walkthrough of AEM, logout, restart AEM, and stop AEM. Through the command prompt, I have ensured that JDK is installed in my machine. As you see, I have the CQ kickstart file and license properties. I have the AEM 6.4 version. Here is sample license.properties file. It will have the license entry as shown here. To install AEM, I need to double click on this kickstart file. So as you see, there is a new folder get created. Now the AEM is getting installed. As you see, it says like starting kickstart on port 4502. Now, as you see, the login console is opened after the installation. If you look at the folder, we'll have a CRX kickstart and all the related files are unzipped in this folder. So we need to log in with the admin credential. So what you're seeing is the dashboard of Adobe Experience Manager. We have projects, sites, experience fragments, assets, forms, screens, personalization, commerce, and communities. If you click on the configuration tools button, we'll have general workflow, operations, sites, assets, resources, deployment, security, commerce, cloud service, communities. We have a search options and configuration for all other Adobe products. When we click on sites, we'll have all the sites related information. So by default, we have the vRetail site. This can be used as a reference while developing the new site. Project section helps us to create new projects. Experience fragment enable us to create experience fragments wherein we can share the AEM site content to third-party devices. Asset is a section wherein we can upload the assets to the AEM. Forms are related to the AEM forms, wherein we can create a user forms and ask the user to submit it. Screens helps us to work with the AEM screens. Personalization is helpful when we need to define the user personalization. Commerce section helps us to integrate with various commerce tools. Communities are the area where we can create user communities. Let me log out. So to stop the AEM, I need to enable the off button. Now the AEM server is down. To restart the AEM server, I need to go to bin. Either click on start or quickstart.bat. I'll just click on the quickstart. You might have noticed that the first setup took around 5 minutes, and this time it was quick. Let me open the AEM console again. Now I have logged in back to the AEM. Sign out. Turn off. So as part of this, we have covered till AEM installation setup, start, stop AEM server. In the upcoming video, I'll be talking about AEM architecture, the building blocks. Thank you.